Let us find out interval of convergence and radius of convergence for the Pass series summation k ranges from 0 to infinity k factorial multiplied to x raised to k. Notice that this Pass series is a Pass series in x, or it is a Pass series about x equals 0. This is of the form summation an x raised to n, where an equals k factorial, or a suffix k equals k factorial. We have radius of convergence r equals limit n tends to infinity un by un plus 1, which is obtained from the ratio test. Recall that by ratio test, whenever limit n tends to infinity un by un plus 1 equals L is a limiting value which is strictly greater than 1, then the given Pass series will be convergent. Otherwise, if L is less than 1, then we will conclude that at those points of x for which L happens to be less than 1 will be the portion where the given Pass series will be divergent. However, in order to find out radius of convergence r, we will have r equals limit n tends to infinity un by un plus 1. Here we have general nth term un equals n factorial times x raised to n, and u suffix n plus 1 equals n plus 1 factorial times x raised to n plus 1. When you evaluate un by un plus 1, you obtain n factorial times x raised to n upon n plus 1 factorial times x raised to n plus 1. We have x raised to n plus 1 can be written as x raised to n multiplied to x, and n plus 1 factorial can be written as n factorial times n plus 1. When n factorial and x raised to n get cancelled from numerator and denominator, you are left out with un by un plus 1 equals 1 upon n plus 1 times x. We have limit n tends to infinity un by un plus 1 will give us radius of convergence, that is capital R, which is the radius of convergence, equals limit n tends to infinity 1 by n plus 1 times x. Limit n tends to infinity has no role for this x because this x is independent of n. When you give n tends to infinity to this term 1 by n plus 1, we will obtain 0 as the answer. This can be considered as limit n tends to infinity 1 by n plus 1 multiplied to limit n tends to infinity applied on 1 by x, but limit n tends to infinity applied on 1 by x has no effect. Since limit n tends to infinity 1 by n plus 1 equals 0, we will have limit n tends to infinity un by un plus 1 equals 0. Therefore, radius of convergence for this infinite series will be r equals 0. Whenever we have radius of convergence is obtained as capital R equals 0, it would mean that the given Pass series will converge only at x equals 0. The general result says that when you consider a Pass series, summation n ranges from 0 to infinity, a suffix n, x minus x naught, the whole raised to n, and if you obtain radius of convergence R equals 0, it would mean that the Pass series has convergence only at the point x equals x naught. Here we have the given Pass series is a Pass series about x equals 0, or it is a Pass series in x. Whenever you consider such a series and radius of convergence is obtained as 0, the Pass series is convergent only at x equals 0. Therefore, the interval of convergence shrinks to just a point x equals 0. Instead of an interval, we are having only a point at which the given Pass series will converge. When we considered the series e raised to x, we had obtained radius capital R equals infinity, from which we obtained the interval of convergence will be the complete real line, which is represented using open interval minus infinity plus infinity. This can be viewed as the interval of convergence ranging from open minus infinity to open positive infinity, and this real line can be assumed to be centered at 0, although any point in the real line can be considered as the center. From the center, the endpoints which are minus infinity or positive infinity are at infinite distance, which corresponds to the radius of convergence of the series e raised to x. For the Pass series, x minus x square by root 2 plus x cube by root 3 minus x raised to 4 by root 4 plus etc., we had evaluated radius of convergence equals capital R equals 1. This follows from the fact that when we evaluated the interval of convergence for this power series is x belongs to open minus 1 comma closed 1. When you consider the interval from minus 1 to 1, that is set of all real values which lies between minus 1 and 1, you can geometrically consider the situation. Suppose 0 is the center of this interval, minus 1 comma 1, then capital R, which denotes the radius of convergence of the power series, will be distance from center to either of the extreme points or the endpoints we have from 0 to minus 1 or from 0 to positive 1. Capital R equals radius of convergence equals 1. Therefore, the geometrical interpretation attributed to radius of convergence and interval of convergence for power series will be, when you consider an interval, open interval x0 minus r, x0 plus r, which is centered at x0, r is the distance from this center to either of the endpoints, and this distance capital R is the radius of convergence. For this power series, summation k ranges from 0 to infinity, k factorial times x raised to h, we have identified that capital R equals 0. Also, this is a power series about x equals 0, or the interval of convergence will be centered at x equals 0. For this case, notice that capital R equals 0, x naught equals 0. That is, the interval of convergence just confines itself to just a point x naught equals 0 or x equals 0. Or you can consider it as the interval 0, 0 involving the singleton element 0. Therefore, capital R equals 0, with the interpretation that from center to the endpoints, the distance equals 0.